Hi, my name is Travis Ormsby. I'm a technical lead here at Esri. In this video, I'll show you how you can improve your data integrity by using arcade expressions to create constraint and validation attribute rules. We have a feature class of parcels, and every time we add a new parcel, we want to make sure that the city and the zip code match. We could try to do that with some combination of subtypes, domains, and contingent values, but attribute rules give us a little bit more flexibility. We've already prepared our table by adding global IDs and editor tracking, so we're ready to add our rule. Right-click, Data Design, Attribute Rules. There are two types of rules we might consider for this scenario. Constraint rules prevent invalid values from ever being written to the table. They're good when we know what kinds of values will be bad. Validation rules flag potentially invalid values for later review. They're good when we need some human judgment to be sure. In our case, we won't know which values are valid or not until we do a little bit more research, so we're going to add a validation rule. We'll give it a name, let's call it zip match, and a description, ensure that city and zip match. Now we're ready to build our expression. We know that there are an array of potentially valid zip codes for each city, and I have a couple of examples for the cities of Linden and Spring Lake in North Carolina. What we'd like to do is, given the name of a city, return the array of acceptable zip codes. And we can do that with the decode function. Decode takes a value, like the value in the city field, and maps it to some other value. So if the city is Linden, it will return the array of zip codes that are valid for Linden. If the city is Spring Lake, it will return the array of zip codes that are valid for Spring Lake. Decode also needs to know what to do if the city is not found in the function, and in our case, we will return an empty array. We need to assign the output of this function to a variable. Let's call it allowed zips. Now, both validation and constraint rules need to return a Boolean value, true if the value is valid, false otherwise. We need to know if the value that was written to the zip field is in the array of allowed zips. And the arcade function that can do that for us is called includes. Includes takes a value, an array, like allowed zips, and a value, like the value in the zip code field. And it returns true if that value is in the array and false otherwise. That's what we want, so we're going to return the output from the includes function. We'll verify that our expression is valid and save it. Now we can add an error number, let's call it number one, and a message, city and zip must match. And we can save our attribute rule. Now, when an editor adds a new parcel point, we'll add one over here by Spring Lake, and we'll give it some attributes. Give it a city, Spring Lake, and an invalid zip code. We can save our edits. And later, when our data reviewer wants to check on the values, it can run the Evaluate Rules geoprocessing tool against the geodatabase. We'll run the tool, and what it does is it creates a few validation feature classes. We'll take the one for our point errors and add this to our map. And there is one potentially invalid value here. Our data reviewer can do some research, find out what fixes, if any, are needed based on the flag that was provided by the validation rule. With constraint and validation attribute rules, you can promote data integrity automatically using more sophisticated rules than are available using only subtypes, domains, and contingent values.